Is there a class vote in Venezuela?
Venezuela, like most Latin American countries, has big class differences. For our documentary, Venezuela in Context, we wanted to know if what the government claims is true, that it represents the poor and working classes and the opposition the rich. For this, we created an interactive diagram that lets you yourself visualize data from all presidential elections since 1998 and compare it to data from the 2001 and 2011 census. In the standard view you find on our website, the bubbles are all parishes. That's the smallest territorial political unit in Venezuela. Red bubbles are urban parishes and blue bubbles are rural parishes. And the size of the bubble represents how many people live in them. The more to the left a bubble is, the less poverty there is, and therefore they're probably rich. And the more to the right a bubble is, the more poverty there is. The lower the bubble is, the fewer people voted for Chavez in this parish. And the higher the bubble is, the more people voted for Chavez in this parish. So if there really were a class vote, you'd expect a pattern from down here, where parishes with little poverty also support Chavismo little, to up here, where parishes with a lot of poverty also support Chavismo a lot more. The general picture that emerges from this is the following. In the 98 election, there really isn't any pattern. Chavez came to power on a protest vote.
Claro, seguramente tú, Jaime, has leído tantas cosas que se han dicho y se han escrito sobre mí. No, yo no soy socialista.
Then towards 2000 and 2004, his confrontational and authoritarian style quickly upset established elites. And he lost many allies who initially supported him.
Yo tengo derecho a responderle.
Claro,
lo que es igual
pero a trampa, exacto, estoy totalmente de acuerdo. Pero a responder dentro de las líneas de un presidente.
Claro, no, yo no puedo maniatarme por ser presidente, yo soy un combatiente. Si a mí me ataca alguien a través de una cadena.
Tiene derecho a defenderse.
De manera, a defenderme y atacar también.
Y mejor, atacar también,
la,
lógico, pero...
La mejor defensa es el ataque.
Sí, pero recuerde una cosa, la mejor defensa es el ataque militarmente hablando, pero usted no está montado en un tanque, está en la silla de Miraflores.
No, la política,
¿y qué le puede ocurrir?
La política es igualito que la guerra.
No, dice que es la extensión
la
de la guerra.
La ciencia de la política
pero
es igualita
a la ciencia
de la guerra.
Pero le puede ocurrir que se puede privar de gente valiosa, porque yo el miedo que le tengo esos ataques. Es que le van quitando gente con la cual usted necesita gobernar con esa gente.
Hasta ahora no ha sido así.
From 2002 to 2003, things came to a head during the absolute low point in his popularity. He was shortly ousted from office by the military, there was a 3 months general strike, and Chavez gained control over the national oil company PDVSA. The opposition then gathered signatures for a recall referendum, which Chavez knew he would have lost. So he delayed the referendum for about a year and created the famous Misiones, the social programs, to shore up his popularity. This coincided with a big rise in world oil prices, which increased the government's revenues, Venezuela's growth, and reduced unemployment and poverty. Finally, Chavez won the delayed referendum and became wildly popular again. The oil-induced economic growth and the Misiones led to an important reduction in poverty, and we'll talk about that in our documentary, which one was more important, the growth or the Misiones.
Se me ocurrió lanzar la frase, patria. Socialismo o muerte.
Now there really starts to emerge something that looks like a class vote until Chavez's last election in 2012. Finally, the support for his successor Maduro in the 2013 election declines in all sectors of society. So here we are today. If you squint your eyes a little, you see something like a class vote pattern. But it's not at all perfect. So parishes with 20% poverty, for example, support Maduro anywhere from 80 to 20%. So yes, overall there is a slight tendency, but the class vote is definitely not as clear nor as important as the government's rhetoric would make you believe.